Namaskar and warm greetings from the Northeastern Institute of Ayurveda and Homeopathy, Shillong. The Government of India has shown interest to develop Ayush system in Northeastern regions, particularly for creating quality human resource. Government of India has established this institute, Northeastern Institute of Ayurveda and Homeopathy.
The Northeastern Institute of Ayurveda and Homeopathy is a national institute of a very unique kind, because this is the campus where both the disciplines of Ayurveda and Homeopathy are in one campus.
The institute has been conceived and proposed in 2008. Later on, it has been commissioned in 2016. Both the colleges are going to catering the needs of the entire eight state of Northeastern state. We are having students from all the eight states along with pan-Indian nature. And right now we are having around 550 students. Regarding infrastructures, we have a full-fledged two hospital building, two full-fledged college building for both colleges, and we have a very rich library along with administrative block. And there are some upcoming facilities are also there. Almost going to finish the three numbers of hostel, one hostel for senior resident, another for boys and another for girls. Simultaneously, we are having three blocks of quarters for faculties along with directors' quarters.
This hospital has two sections, the Ayurveda and Homeopathy, and we have all the OPDs functioning. And in Ayurveda, we have Kaya Chikitsa, Shalya, Panchakarma, and Prasuti Tantra, and Sri Rog, Kumar Bhritya, and other departments as well. And the Panchakarma Theatre is a very well-functioning unit in our hospital, and we have many patients coming especially for Panchakarma. The other facilities that we have are the minor OT and the two major OTs. We have well-equipped labor room. And we also have casualty, which opens 24 hours, manned by a medical officer. So we cater to the emergency cases as well. And we have the diagnostic facilities like the central laboratory, where most of the basic investigations, the routine tests are done here. And we have the radiology department like ultrasound, X-ray and ECG. And we have expert technicians also in these departments. And in the homeopathy section also, we have all the functioning OPDs manned by the consultants and doctors.
Myself, Dr. Vishnu Chaudhary, College of Ayurveda, Department of Kaya Chikitsa. Kaya Chikitsa is one of the basic department, an important department in Ayurveda system of medicines. In modern language, we can say Kaya Chikitsa means general medicine. In Department of Kaya Chikitsa, deals with different physical and psychological disorders. In our hospital, under Department of Kaya Chikitsa, we used to get huge number of cases of gastrointestinal disorders, metabolic and endocrine disorders like diabetes mellitus, thyroid disorders, different lifestyle disorders like hypertension, obesity, respiratory disorders, and skin disorders. There is a very good treatment and huge scope for treatment of such kind of diseases, as I mentioned, and we used to treat successfully. Last 9.5 years of experience in this institute, I have treated huge number of cases of this disease, as mentioned. In this current pandemic situation, COVID-19, everybody knows, we have treated around 1,500 cases of COVID-19 positive cases through Ayurvedic medicine only. If you use this medicine along with the conventional medicine as per the government protocol, there is early clinical recovery and there is no chances of progression of disease. So we can treat COVID-19 very successfully with Ayurvedic medicines. And the basic aim of Ayurveda is preventive of different disorders and treatment of ailments. So both we can achieve through Ayurveda. It's one of the holistic system of medicines, and we can have better health, both preventive, we can prevent many diseases, and we can treat it many diseases which cannot be treated in other pathies. In last few years of this institute, we have taken few research project. Recently we have undertaken 5 research project on COVID-19 for prophylaxis and treatment. We got very positive results for mitigation of COVID-19 through Ayush medications.
My name is Dr. Om Prakash Patel. I am working as a lecturer in Department of Homeopathic Pharmacy since August 2016. College of Homeopathy is a unit of near Shillong. In College of Homeopathy, we have 12 departments. In these 12 departments, 4 departments are purely homeopathic, and all other 8 departments are anatomy, physiology, pathology, forensic medicine and toxicology, gynecology and obstetrics, surgery, practice of medicine and community medicine. In homeopathy, course name is Bachelor of Homeopathic Medicine and Surgery, that is also named as BHMS. This course is of 4.5 years with 1 year rotatory internship. First year is of 1 year, second year is of 1 year, third year is of 1 year, fourth year is of 1.5 years. In this internship, a student learns about the patient care and OPD, IPD care. In homeopathic system of medicine is recognized worldwide, and even in India it is a recognized system of medicine. In this recognized system of medicine, like allopathy, Ayurveda, Yunani, Siddha, homeopathy is also blooming all over India. In homeopathic system of medicine, a student get BHMS degree, and after that they pursue PG degree, that is MD homeopathy. And after that, nowadays in some of the universities there are PhD in homeopathy is also there. In NIA, we have admitted our student in 2016-17, that is our first batch, and now our students are in internship.
Hi, I'm Dr. Anvesha Das. I am an intern here and I'm from Assam. I was admitted to this college in 2016 and we were the first batch here. After I came here, I was lucky enough that everything went smooth, and I'm blessed enough to get the knowledge of Ayurveda from highly qualified doctors from all over India. Not only in studies, but also we are given equal importance in extracurricular activities, sports, cultural events. We have our own cultural fest. And being Ayurvedic student, we have to get a proper knowledge on the medicinal plants. And for that purpose, we have a very beautiful medicinal plant garden in our hospital and college area, where we can refer anytime we want. Apart from that, we also have a very good canteen, and the view of the college is an add-on to it.
My name is Chainika. I'm basically from Guwahati. I am a student of homeopathy, although I have completed my graduation this year only very recently. Now I am working as an intern here in the homeopathy hospital. Before coming here, we have to appear in NEET. We have to crack the entrance, and I got chance to take admission in homeopathy. At the beginning, I have really very little knowledge about this pathy. As we all know, like in Northeast, homeopathy is not much developed like in the other part of the country. But then the time I have got admitted here, I got exposure to the teachers, our faculty members first, then slowly the patient. And I got the chance to learn more and more as the days pass. The very first thing which amazed me about this college is the campus. It is really very, very, very beautiful. I think this is the very unique feature of this institute, and this institute is the only one institute in the Northeast, whole Northeast, which have two colleges at the same place.
So I think within next 3 to 4 years, it will having a very good infrastructure and will catering the different need of IUS system, and it will consider to be one of the premier academic institute in the IUS. And it is very interesting that Almighty has given a very favorable climatic conditions, very good quality soil for growing of natural medicinal plants with good vegetation, with flora and fauna in their Northeast regions. Not only pertaining education or healthcare, further it is for research, and it will go into advantage for propagating Ayush in the South Asian countries, and it will going to boost economic sectors also, either in healthcare sector, both in private sector and government sector, along with pharmaceutical industry based on herbs as well as cultivation of medicinal plants. So if we have the proper training and motivation is done for the young generation of the Northeastern regions, I think this center will be epicenter for creating new thoughts and creating new generations for economic transformations. And moreover, as Government of India's present policies to look towards East and communication in South Asia, so definitely this center will be one of the milestone for supporting the herbal and agro-waste industry, whether you can say cultivation of medicinal plant, marketing of the medicinal plant, processing and pharmaceutical in the based on this, as well as it may be in other sectors also, like extending medical tourism with Panchakarma, because you know Northeast region is having a very tremendous scope for tourism. So if Ayurveda, particularly Panchakarma, is blended with tourism, it will be very beneficial for promoting tourism, and it will give relief to the poorer sections, those who are directly or indirectly related to tourism industry, because entire Northeastern region have small pockets for tourist attractions, but there is a shortage of retaining facilities for the tourists. So if we are developing their tourism along with Panchakarma, then I think definitely it will be a new feeder in the cap of tourism industry. And I hope in coming years, this institute definitely helpful for contribute immensely in the healthcare sector, particularly to educate the people to practice self-healing process and preventive of diseases and promotion of health by practicing the principles of Ayurveda and Yoga. Thank you very much.